Good morning, my children, and welcome to your English class, the class of the teacher Jacob. So, for today, my children, we're going to commence with a new letter of this review. Remember, we already saw multiple times, actually, we saw the letter A in two forms, capital A, which in Spanish, A mayúscula, and small a in Spanish means A minúscula. We already saw that letter. We already saw objects that we associate with that letter. Today, we're going to start with the second letter of the alphabet, the letter B, okay? Now remember, again, one more time, all of the letters, todas las letras, recuerden, have two forms, tienen dos formas, capital letters, mayúsculas, small letters, minúsculas. In the case of capital B, okay, I'm going to show you the form of this letter. Capital B, a line with two semicircles. Okay, these two circles, los dos círculos que conforman la letra B, no están completos, son semicírculos, la mitad. Tenemos dos y una línea que los une, es la forma de capital B. Now, once again, remember each one of the letters in both forms, en ambas formas, have their own objects, tienen sus propios objetos. So, for today, we're going to check some of the objects that we can see with the capital B. Now, remember, we're going to explain characteristics, and at the end of this, we're going to make the pronunciation exercise. So, let's begin. The first object with the capital B is the baby. Now, the name of this baby, you may know it, okay? The name of this baby is Jack-Jack, and this baby, it's a character that appears on the movie The Incredibles, okay? Now, Jack-Jack has a lot of superpowers. He's a superhero. Now, this baby, or babies in general, remember, are small people, son gentes pequeñitas, that they still don't know how to walk, todavía no saben caminar, they still don't know how to talk, todavía no pueden comunicarse bien, and they are always asleep, y siempre están dormidos, los babies, okay? So, baby with capital B. Let's continue with another object. The second object with the letter B in capital form is the bag. Now, the bag, it's an object most common for girls. Es más común que las niñas, las mujeres lo usen, okay? But in some occasions, there are also bags for boys. También puede haber para niños, but it's more common for the girls, okay? Now, the bag is just an object in which we put all of our things, todas nuestras cosas, we put it in a bag. Do you remember the backpack, for example? ¿Recuerdan ustedes backpack, una mochila? Okay, in this case, the bag doesn't have zippers, no tiene cierres, okay? Most of the bags are used, son usados with buttons, like the one that appears here in the middle, okay? So we have the bag with capital B. Let's continue with the third object. For the next object, we have the ball. Now remember, the ball is part of the family of toys. Es parte de la familia de los juguetes. And we have several balls because there are several sports in the world. Tenemos diferentes tipos de pelotas porque en el mundo hay diferentes tipos de deportes. For example, the one that is here on the whiteboard is a basketball, okay? It's a basketball ball because this is part of the basketball game. Remember, the basketball game is when you use your hands. Okay, es donde utilizamos las manos. Now, the other ball is the one that the one with the soccer game, el juego de fútbol. That ball is jugada with only the feet, con los pies, and not the hands like the basketball. Okay, se utiliza con los pies en el soccer y no con las manos como lo hacemos en el basketball. Another ball is the football, okay, la de fútbol americano, that's another type of ball, otro tipo de pelota, but in this case, looks like an egg, tiene forma de huevo, okay? So, there are also balls that we use for tennis, los que usamos para jugar tenis. El juego de tenis es un juego en donde necesitamos de dos personas y cada una de ellas tiene una raqueta para pasar la pelota de un lado a otro. Now, for that game, we have small, pequeñas, small balls, color green, the color green. So we have several types of balls for several types of sports, okay? De acuerdo al deporte, es la pelota que tendremos que usar. Very good. So, the last subject of today are the balloons, or the balloon if it's only one. Si se trata de solamente uno, balloon. If they are two or more, si son mucho más, balloons with S. Now, the balloons that appear here, okay? Once again, the balloon, it's like a toy, es parte de la familia de los juguetes, okay? The balloon, we expose it on the air, es un objeto que ponemos al aire, we grab it by the string, lo sujetamos de un hilo, okay? Because if we don't grab it, the string, si nosotros no sujetamos ese hilo, the balloon goes away, el globo se va, y hasta te queda allá arriba en el cielo. So in order not that to happen, para que no pase eso, we have to grab the string, tenemos que agarrar el hilo, okay, muy fuerte. Very good. Now, another characteristic of the balloon is the form, es su forma. Remember, the balloon looks like an oval, looks like an egg, parece un óvalo, un huevo. And in the case of the ball, remember, looks like a circle, parece un círculo. Very good. Now, let's make the pronunciation exercise. Remember, for this, my children, the teacher Jacob says the word first. Yo digo primero la palabra, then you repeat it. Después ustedes la repiten with all of your energy, very, very loud, bien fuerte, so I can hear the pronunciation, para que pueda escuchar cómo lo dicen. Let's start. Baby. Very good. Bach. Okay, one more time, a little bit louder. Bach. Ball, balloon. Very good, excellent. Now, the most important part of this object is that all of them, todos estos, they begin, van a empezar with the capital B. Also, name of people, for example, Brenda or Brian, Brenda and Brian, those are two names, okay? Names of people that begin with the letter B. Brenda, Brian son ejemplos de nombres de personas que empiezan con la letra B, okay? También es muy importante el reconocer nombres con esta nueva letra. So that's it for today, my children. I hope that you have an excellent day. As always, remember the teacher Jacob loves you very much. Take care. Goodbye.